Hey guys, it's your average gamer, Kirkie here. Today we're going to do something we haven't done in a long time. We are going to play a Mega Man fan game. This time around, it's Rocko-chan. This actually showed up on YouTube for me as a random video on the homepage. And I was like, I'm going to look into this because it's interesting. Didn't watch the video though, so sorry to the person's video. I didn't watch it because I didn't want to spoil myself on it too much. But yeah, the game is indeed Rocko-chan. It, from what I can tell, is a Flash game, but Flash is dead now, so the best you can do is download it and play it, which, if you guys do want to try this one for yourself, link will be in the description as always. Game. And, there's no native controller support for this as well, I should also point out. So, if you want to use a controller, you need something like X-Padder in order to map keyboard controls to the controller. So this is going like true old school here. Freaking hell. I will have to remember to... Can I leave? I will have to remember to actively go out of my way to put or mark the password down. Or I can just look at the video afterwards if we continue on with the series, which... Ideally, if I can get through it, we're going to go through it. That's kind of the whole reason I started this. In any case, this right here, six bosses, very reminiscent of Mega Man. Kind of also reminds me of Mega Man 2 because of the background. So I don't know who to start with, in all honesty. So we're going to do like this. I'm going to do a 3-2-1 countdown, and whatever we land on, that is what we'll play. So, 3-2-1... go. Okay, great. Fire stage starting off. Volcano Man. I don't see any problems with this. Fire stages are typically hard in Mega Man games. Okay. Things seem a little broken here. Oh, I fell. I don't know if it's supposed to be like... well, there's a pit there. I'm pretty sure it's not supposed to be like this. I feel like that's the case. So, oh yeah, we have a dash. Woo! I didn't go in the hole, at least. Oh, there we go, the stage loaded up proper. And it's widescreen. What? So that's what I... So here's my guess. This game, and I'll alt-tab out to show you, not alt-tab, I'll go out of full screen. This game is natively 4x3. So I am thinking the Flash player kind of messes things up a little bit. And it's going, like when I load into the game or put a full screen, it's going 16x9. And even when you go full screen like this, it's 16x9, which messes it up. What if I go out of full screen or, yeah, that's exactly what's doing it. Weird. I don't want to play it small like this, guys. So you know what? We're going to have to just put up with the blackness for the start of each stage. And I'm actually going to burn my lives off since there was a pit here and I died in it the first time. This way I can start again with full lives and we can have a little better time about it. So we'll wait for the enemy to show up. Enemy. There you are. That lets us know where the hole is. And now, come on. There we go. We got the stage back in play. Whew. I thought those flames were going to be a little higher. Okay. A little higher than they were. I love the maneuver. Ah! Damn it. I love the maneuverability in this already, though. Like, the dashes? Top tier. This, it gives me huge Mega Man X vibes because of that, and I absolutely love it. What I don't love, though, is these freaking things just popping out here every time. And the fact that we don't seem to have a charge shot. Oh, God! I thought once I killed one off, it would be gone. Okay, well, we're learning. And what we're learning is I'm going to go in this hole one more time and burn off my last life, because if I haven't made it past this first screen, I don't want to make it to the boss and have to do this all over again. So let's just burn off that life now and be done. Oh my God. No, I'm not going to mention what I pointed or what I saw, because it's so many levels are wrong. It feels wrong that they did that, but sure, you guys see what it is. Okay, there we go. What dropped out of you? Okay. We'll wait that out. Whoop! Yeah, things move, like, really fast, really smooth. Okay, no. Yoku blocks straight off the bat, really? You jump really high, too. I like that, though. That's a nice little trope. Whoop! I could see this one being fun to actively speedrun, I think. Let's get me in. Oh, God. Well, we should be able to jump right up on that. Okay. Whoop! Oh, my God. I tried to bridge the gap, and I figured it would work, but it probably would have had I not cowered out and let go of a direction. When I saw that pop up, I didn't chant it, and it was stupid. I should have just stuck with it. Okay, so there's an E-Tank up there, no abilities to switch to yet. So we won't be getting ourselves an E-Tank. Come on. It's always seemed crazy to me that... Oh my God, calm down, buddy. It's always seemed crazy to me when people made full games out of on Flash like this just for people to play online for free. To play a game from your browser, even in today's society, you don't see a whole heck of a lot of it. Whew! Glad that thing eventually died. I'm holding in the button as if I'm charging. Makes no difference. Is it just me, or did the widescreen aesthetic kind of go away? Because it looks like the widescreen aesthetic kind of went away. This is really confusing. Oh my God, you're a miserable thing to deal with. Can't make it up on there. I almost seemed like I could. I fetched in a weird way. Oh, widescreen's back. Oh, no, it's gone again. Ow. I'm just gonna stay down here until he dies and then wait this stuff out. There. Oh, come on! I didn't even see that thing! Tell me the truth, did any of you actually see that thing sitting there? Nope! A lot of transitional screens. Oh, no. I don't like auto-scrollers in my Mega Mans. I do like the fact that we can jump higher and all get out, though. We can actually get ahead of the screen. I would love to have that one up, but I'm not going to risk it. The dashing makes this especially satisfying. I'm starting to get worried because I was expecting it. Oh no, not again. I'm going to assume this is all safe. Oh boy, there's a danger spot though. Well, at least the obstacles that we... Oh, great, they move. Oh my God, finally the screen loaded in. We're playing the hard version, guys. Jeez. No! Now I gotta do the blind stuff again. Oh, come on! Okay, made it here. Not the greatest at health. Man, I would have loved to have had that because I think that was a health drop. Well, just gonna have to hope things don't go horribly, horribly wrong this time. My God, that's some risky stuff there. I hope all the stages don't have an empty spot like that. Or spot where things go invisible, but I expect them to. Okay? Okay, calm down, dude. I have to figure out... Oh my God, I only do one hit of damage at a time. Okay, so we're not beating this boss. That much is for sure. Really wish I could cheat and use a save state or something, but unfortunately that's not a possibility. Okay, you're doing different stuff this time, buddy. Oh my God. Chan, whatever your name was. I was gonna call her Roll, but I don't think she's... Oh my God. I had nowhere I could go! You shoot too fast, dude. I can hit you ones, you can hit me fours. This is ridiculous, man. I gotta go through the blind part of this stage again. I'm not happy about that. This right here, in all honesty, is one of my most hated things about Mega Man games. When you die, having to play the whole damn stage again. Even worse, when you have to do it blind. Alright, so we're back here at the boss. I've died to him once already because I was almost out of health and I figured it wasn't worthwhile. Even when I die this time, I'm going to find somewhere that I can hopefully grind out a few lives. Because, my God, this boss is stupidly difficult. Which is, for me personally, always been like a problem with not even just fan games, but Mega Man in general. Like, it's never been a new friendly game or a casual gamer kind of game. You have to be really good at games in order to get past something like this without beating your face off for like 2 hours. This is looking like it's going to be beat your face off this for 2 hours. Okay. Things are going better this time at least. No way to know where they're going to come down is a bad thing. So all you can do is kind of hope you get lucky. Which there I didn't. And he shot in the only open spot I had. Not fair, man. Do other stuff! I had to back off because that's the worst thing he could possibly do, and he keeps doing that over and over. The other stuff gives you a chance to evade, but if that comes down randomly in a pattern where the only safe spot you have is where they're coming down, you have to pull back and you're getting hit. This boss has a bit of a flaw, and it's the RNG-ness of his, not this shot, but this shot. Nope, he didn't do it this time. If he kept doing this, it wouldn't be so bad. This crap shot. If it doesn't cooperate with you, you're taking the hit. I thought maybe it was a placement thing, but that doesn't seem to be it. Yeah, I'm not sure what the trigger is for this shot. Whether it is just random at first. Nope, that definitely confirms that's not the case. He's doing it whenever I'm super close to him now as well. I thought it was like if I was too close to him, he would do that shot, but that doesn't seem to be the case. It's just pure randomness as far as I can tell. That pure randomness is what's killing me more than anything else, because it's such poor placements and the balls move so fast, you have so little time to react and try to find the open spot that they aren't. And if you're already past it, you're taking a hit from his downward shot like this. Garbage. I wish I could get more than one shot off at a time. But this is Mega Man in a nutshell. There's a reason this series has always pissed me off when I've played it. See, that time it worked out fine because most of the stuff went behind me. And that one worked out fine because there was a spot in front of me, but it doesn't always go like that is the problem. Except for now, just to effing prove me wrong. Is his legs trash cans? His legs sure look like trash cans to me. I don't mind this one. This one here is not actually as bad to block as this one. But now, he sees I'm almost dead. The jerkwad's going to go back to that one again. Okay. Boom. Come on. One more hit. Probably for me too. Jesus. Tough effing starting boss, man. Really effing tough starting boss. Almost 25 minutes to get through this opening stage. Counting the stage, the opening to all of this, it was a skippable cutscene. I was going to say the unskippable cutscene, but it was definitely a skippable cutscene. Mental note, use this if needed, but I plan on doing one more stage, so now it becomes the guessing game. I'm guessing fire is going to be good against forest, so that's where I'll go next. Oh, that was a vine. Forest Man! And the start of the stage, much like the last one, is... Oh, what? I got vibrations, what? Weird. The controller vibrated for some reason. I'm not sure what that reason would possibly be. Okay, I'm really hoping by now things would come back into place. No? Okay, then. I don't know if I can touch this, or if I'm supposed to be going on. Okay, there's a thing right here. Monkey, show yourself. Why do you have to take more than one hit? You're so high up. Okay. Where the monkey fell, there was nothing to drop on. I'm going to assume that stuff is going to hurt. Oh, no, it doesn't hurt me. Cool. Oh, little bees. At least he doesn't seem to be much of a threat. I'm curious what happens if I go all the way under in this. Oh, great. This stage decides it wants to disappear afterward as well. No spikes. Good. We just sink slowly. So, blind jump. Hope for the best. Oh, fantastic. It gets even better. Move! Oh, we can see again a little bit. Awesome. Oh my god. You know what? You guys, I don't care. I don't care. I want nothing to do with you. I don't. Oh, no, we're blind again. I did see there was a hole right here that I apparently have to go down. God damn it. We're playing most of this stage blind and it sucks. Well, god damn it. I don't know what I hit. I went to hit Alt and Enter and I hit Alt and something else and it reset the game on me. So that's that progress gone. Fantastic. Things are going so well so far. I just wanted to see if there was a way I could make this bigger. Just anything that would make it nominally bigger so it doesn't break in the worst of ways like it has been. Well, even this doesn't fix it. There is no winning, man. We are screwed either way, it would seem. Unless I want to... Wait. You can see way far ahead if you want to. Interesting. Don't understand why if it's windowed like this, up to a certain size, it seems to work just fine. Even widescreen. Oh, no, we broke it there. So, like, right there is our absolute limit. We go past this point, and she breaks. So, I guess we're playing this in ultra-widescreen format, 21:9. Not sure how this is going to work out for recording or editing, but sure, I got to go through this again because... Guess what? I didn't write the password down. Everything feels so weird because I'm so far back. Everything's so small. Alright, so I stopped the recording so I could grab the password, make things a little bit easier. And I'm hoping this format is going to work a little more beneficial here. I won't know until I get into Forest Man stage. Provided I can get back over onto the screen here. Jeez. Let's see how it goes. Let's get this out of your guys' way. Forest Man! We have one life, so we'll, oh great, still black screen. God damn it. Is it too wide? Like, I don't want to have to play this in a super duper tiny screen. That doesn't make sense. I want to at least be able to see what I'm doing. Nah, it's not going to cooperate. It does not like 4K. That's what I'm learning. Above a certain resolution, it is not happy. Right there is about the limit. Fine, I got a different workaround for this. We'll bring the game size. Oh, right. Never thought about that. You know what, we'll do it like this. We'll hit, see if we can go full screen first off without it breaking too bad. Okay, yeah, this seems like it's gonna work. So here we are. Anytime I go to play this on the TV, I'm just gonna have to put it to 1080p and oh my God, the coloring is so terrible. But everything is here, so yay! Stuff still loads in weird, but I'm trying to get them to kill me off so I can... Oh my God, be faster. You seem to do the least amount of damage possible. Quit being the one that hits me. Ghost, come here, bees. Yeah, for me, you guys have nice vibrant colors and stuff. Wait, what? Oh, apparently when you put the password in, they give you your lives back. Well, God damn it. I'm just going to rush through this and find somewhere to die a couple times then. Alright, so now that we're not going to be completely cheated, I can see what's going on and whatnot. Let's do this for realsies. You know, being able to see where all the ground and stuff is actually kind of really nice. Kind of sucks that going above 1080p breaks this, though. It doesn't make a whole heck of a lot of sense, but it is what it is. Nothing to do about it, right? So we'll bust these out. Roll has a dash, but she does not have a slide, so you gotta just spam the crap out of stuff. Please, sir, move. Stop trying to keep the woman down. Alright, so we gotta go down this hole, apparently. Which, there's no real indicator that that's the case until you go past it and start shooting the other thing. Okay, so we can only hurt that thing by hitting it in the ass in. Why do all... It seems to be a requirement of Mega Man at this point. You despawn if I go too far over. All water stages require spikes for some reason. I don't like this jump. Oh God, that was scary. Nope. Only about half as scary as these jerks. But help, game. I need help. Thank you. I need help even more. Still nothing.
true to Mega Man style here. Can't get help when you need it or anything. Okay, oh. Hello. What part of you am I looking to shoot? Okay, the head. Oh, great. Now these won't stop following me, please. Yep. That went well. Oh, and that wasn't even the halfway point. Even better. Okay, so we're here again, at least. I had to stop to get help, and I gained more lives than I did health drops. So I'm just going to use this thing and hope that it doesn't waste too much on us while we take this guy out. Because I am kind of hoping that's going to be the weakness coming up. If it isn't, then oops. Okay, yep, could definitely use both of these. Looks like they expect you to use this. But God, if you're me, you hate to waste the powers because you don't know it's going to be the weakness on the boss. And there's never any guarantees to gain stuff back, right? Oh, fantastic. This is a terrible layout for everything. I can get so few shots on these jerks. Boy, your drops never... Oh, no, there it went. I was going to say, drops never go away, but they do. You know what? I'm just going to go over you now. Sometimes your jump seems to go higher than other times as well. Oh, we're back to this issue. But here, it could be that's how it's made. I don't think it is, but... Yeah, we're definitely back to this issue again. That's unfortunate. Thought that we had solved... Oh my god, another life? Are you kidding me? Thought that we had solved this issue by at least going to 1080p, but I guess not. Alright, we've gone back to caveman times now. We are down to 720p in hopes that that'll make it better. It's blurry as old F on my end, but hopefully for you guys it's a little better. Now, oh, I can't move. There we go. I'm in the game again. Fantastic. Let's try that again. So yeah, hopefully it'll decide that it doesn't want to be a jerk and screw us. Ah, why did you not grab that? So I can say it's this TV at 720p, there's an awful after image. So whenever I jump like this, I can see half of Rocco, I think her name was. I see half of anything that moves behind it, giving it a proper ghosting effect. I'm just gonna skip you guys since, oh, that jump barely made it. Yeah, I don't know why the jumps are so much bigger sometimes compared to others. Well, stuff stayed here this time at least. My god, the visuals are, oh, what? I'm not sure what the ticket is to grab these things. It just, is it, I hold up? Well, then why didn't it work back there? And this is a bad one because if it doesn't decide it wants to grab onto it, you're dead. Oh great, a monkey. A monkey up high enough that I won't be able to hit from it. Stop it. Okay, now if this one screws me, we are screwed totally. Hoo-yah! I definitely want that E-tank. Get away from me! Actually, we're gonna let you- Oh my god, that monkey can freaking snipe me, man. Okay. Oh god, that is scary because it doesn't want to be consistent. No! Oh, good. That did knock me off. I was totally expecting it to knock me off. Hooah! There we go. A little worse for wear damage. Oh, come on. Really? I got to deal with some... Good. We got through with a tiny little bit of health left. We can at least see what we do here for damage. All right, Vine Whip Man. Die. That is indeed the weakness, and it killed me immediately. He killed me immediately. Didn't even think about hesitating. I really wish this would at least work at 1080p. It didn't look so grody as it does here. Stuff even seems stretched more vertically or something. Boy, the iframes seem non-existent here. I almost feel bad for this boss. Not too bad though, because it's come back to kick me, or kick my ass. I don't say kick me in the ass, but yeah, there's definitely, you guys won't see it, but I definitely see a huge ghosting effect because this TV's garbage. But we beat that, sort of, and we turn nice and forest green. We got a forest whip and beetle jet. Ooh! Taking a mental note, click, click. Totally not taking a mental note. I'll just grab this from the freaking video when I go to edit.
Oh my god. Either way, that's two bosses down, four to go. If you guys know who to go for next, let me know in the comments down below. If you don't, that's fine too. Who do you think we should go for next will be the other way. This isn't even lined up right. At least not for me. That's why. So, I don't know. Well, you guys can't see the mouse pointer, but... yeah, you guys see the whole screen. I don't. It's getting cut off up to the top and bottom. Either way, check out these videos off to the side. I'm going to hope to find out a better way to play this. I'm not playing it at 720p. There's too much wrong with it. And yeah, look forward to the next part. Because I think I've shown myself at the very least I can get through this. So we'll do what we can with that. I'm not going to make any promises not to get mad though. See you guys in the next one.